Can we talk about music? Or can music talk for itself? Let's find out. My name is Olga Jegunova, and this is Talking Music. It seems that corona crisis has affected our social skills. We have to relearn how to talk to each other, how to have a dialogue, how to listen to each other. Let's talk about something very, very important today. Let's talk about friendship. You may wonder why a podcast on classical music suddenly touches upon a relationship theme. It's simple. Let me quote Plato here, who said, "Music gives a soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and life to everything." You see, life to everything. To me personally, music is life, and life is music. And everything that we do and think and fear and dream has already been expressed through music. Friendship amongst it, of course. Not to mention the recent Harvard research saying that happiness is all about happy relationships. Also, there are great examples of strong friendships in music, such as between Mozart and Haydn, Debussy and Satie, Brahms and the Schumanns, Ravel and Gershwin, Mahler and Strauss. But today, I will refer to the main expert of friendship, a Roman philosopher, Cicero. While being philosophical, let's listen to Mahler's Symphony No. 5. And of course, its slow movement called Adagietto. In the year 44 BC, in a period of months, Cicero produced some of the most readable and influential essays ever written on various subjects. Amongst these works were the short essay on friendship, How to Be a Friend. It was dedicated to his close friend Atticus. The heartfelt advice it gives is honest and moving. Some Romans had viewed friendship in mostly practical terms, as a relationship between people for mutual advantage. Cicero doesn't deny that such friendships are important, but he reaches beyond the utilitarian to praise a deeper kind of friendship in which two people find in each other another self who doesn't seek profit or advantage from the other person. Greek philosophers such as Plato and Aristotle had written about friendship hundreds of years earlier. Indeed, Cicero was deeply influenced by their writings. But he goes beyond and creates in this short work a compelling guide to finding, keeping, and appreciating those people in our lives we value not for what they can give us, but because we find in them a kinder soul. How to Be a Friend is filled with timeless advice on friendship, but here are only 10 of them. Number 1. There are different kinds of friendships. Cicero acknowledges that there are many good people we come in contact with in our lives, we call our friends. Be they business associates, neighbors, or any manner of acquaintances. But he makes a key distinction between these common and quite useful friendships and those rare friends we bind ourselves to on a much deeper level. These special friendships are necessarily rare, because they require so much time and investment of ourselves. But these are the friends that deeply change our lives, just as we change theirs. Cicero writes, "With the exception of wisdom, I'm inclined to believe that the immortal gods have given nothing better to humanity than friendship." Number 2. Only good people can be true friends. People of poor moral character can have friends, but they can only be friends of utility, for the simple reason that real friendship requires trust, wisdom, and basic goodness. Number 3. We should choose our friends with care. We have to be deliberate about forming our friendships, as they can be very messy and painful to end. If we suddenly find out that a friend was not the person we thought, we should take our time, move slowly, and discover what lies deep in a person's heart before we make the investment of self that true friendship requires. Number 4. Friends make you a better person. No one can thrive in isolation. Left on our own, we will stagnate and become unable to see ourselves as we are. A true friend will challenge you to become better because he appreciates the potential inside you. Even when a friend is absent, he is still present, says Cicero. Number 5. Make new friends but keep the old. No one is sweeter friend than someone who has been with you from the beginning. But don't limit yourself to the companions of youth, whose friendship may have been based on interests you no longer share. Always be open to new friendships, including those with younger people. Both you and they will be richer for it. Number 6. Friends are honest with each other. Friends will always tell you what you need to hear, not what you want them to say. There are plenty of people in the world who will flatter you for their own purposes, but only a real friend, or enemy really, will risk your anger by telling you the truth. And being a good person yourself, you should listen to your friends and welcome what they have to say. Number 7. The reward of friendship is friendship itself. Cicero acknowledges that there are practical advantages to friendship: advice, companionship, support in difficult times. But at its heart, true friendship is not a business relationship. It doesn't seek repayment, it doesn't keep score. We are not so pretty as to charge interest on our favors, writes Cicero, and then he adds, the reward of friendship is friendship itself. Number 8. A friend never asks another friend to do something wrong. A friend will risk much for another, but not honor. If a friend asks you to lie, cheat, or do something shameful, consider carefully if that person is who you really thought he was. Number 9. Friendships can change over time. Friendships from youth will not be the same in old age, nor should they be. Life changes all of us with time, but the core values and qualities that drew us to friends in years past can survive the test of time. And like the wine, the best of friendships will improve with age. Number 10. Without friends, life is not worth living. Or as Cicero says, suppose a god carried you far away to a place where you were granted an abundance of every material good nature could wish for, but denied the possibility of ever seeing a human being. Wouldn't you have to be as hard as iron to endure that sort of life? Wouldn't you, utterly alone, lose every capacity for joy and pleasure? Cicero's little book on friendship had a tremendous influence on writers in the ages following him, from Saint Augustine to the Italian poet Dante and beyond, and was one of the earliest books translated and printed in English. It is no less valuable today. In a modern age of technology and relentless focus on the self that threatens the very idea of deep and lasting friendships, Cicero has more to say to us than ever. I would like to thank Professor Philip Freeman, who wrote an article in Times magazine dedicated to friendship, How to Be a Friend. Thank you for listening.